Hey guys, my name is Jason with Non-Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, I'm going to demonstrate the 6-inch by 30-inch jaw crusher here behind me. We sell a lot of these units to granite countertop shops who crush their remnants and their waste through this machine so they don't have to dump it in the landfill and they can sell the product as gravel. So let's go take a look at some of our samples, then we'll put them through the jaw crusher here. They'll come crushed down into this green bin and we'll take a look. So here's the samples we're going to be running today, and there's two different types. There's a natural stone, which is here on my left, and then there's a man-made product called quartz that's here on my right. And I've split them into the two separate types. We're going to run the natural stone first, and I've actually broken the natural stone down further into a couple different samples. I've got the white stuff here in the front, and then I've got some colored stone in the back that will run separate to show you how you can either run it all through and sell it as gravel, or if you want to sort by color. A lot of our customers get a premium on gravel that's sorted into different colors like black and green and brown and white, for example. And then once we're done with the natural stone, we'll come over to our quartz and we'll crush that through the crusher and I'll show you how that looks. Just a little bit closer look here. This is that natural stone. It comes out of the ground, they mine it. This is all of our white stuff. And then I have three different samples. This is kind of like a dark gray, yellow, brown mix. I've got a brown color here, and then I've got a little bit of black that will run separate. So here's our natural white stone that we crushed, and it's about a 3/4 inch product. But like I said, this is all the same color, and it crushed down real nice. It was about as fast as we could feed it. You can open the jaws a little bit more if you wanted a coarser crush, but a lot of people want this fine 3/4 minus crush for decorative stone, landscape, mulch, filling potholes in their driveways, whatever. So there's the natural stone, white. Now we'll run three different samples of the black, brown, and gray, and we'll show you how those compare. Thank you. Here are the four colored samples that we sorted. Here's the white stuff that we crushed earlier on, and I've gotten them all wet so you can see the color, and it washed off the dust. But we've got the white, and then the brown really comes out. You can really see the colors, and when they're sorted, you can envision them as a landscape mulch, all the same color. This is a really cool one, kind of a black, gray, and off-white. And then the black here really just sparkles in the sunlight. So that's an example of sorting them, or some of our customers just mix it all together, crush it all down into gravel, and sell it as gravel. And here's a quick look at our quartz samples. There's a bunch of different types in here, but they're all essentially little pieces of rock, like this one. They can mix glass in them, rock dust, and then they mix them with a polymer plastic type of thing that binds them all together, and they get these nice smooth countertops. Some of these pieces are real big, but as long as they'll fit down through our 30 inch wide jaw crusher mouth, the crusher will crush them up real nice. All right, this is our quartz engineered stone. Went through the crusher. It's a little bit harder to crush. I don't know, harder is the right word. It seems like it has a little more give than natural stone. It's a little more flexible, I guess, is the word I'm looking for. So it just crushes slower, but everything went through and crushed to this really nice, fine product. And same thing, you can use it for landscape mulch, gravel, whatever. But if nothing else, you really, really reduced your volume and turned your waste into a product that you can now turn around and sell. So when we sell these machines, we sell them with a big loading hopper and a discharge chute so you can direct them into a barrel or a bucket or something onto a conveyor. But on this one, I wanted to show you guys so you could see down inside how it worked, and then we could pull stuff in and out real quick. This is an electric version. It's run with a 20 horsepower three-phase electric motor. We also have a gas model of this size, so if you don't have three-phase power or you want to put it out in the back 40 of your shop yard somewhere and run it away from power, we have an option for that. But also, we have a unit that we call our slab module, our slab crusher module. And it has a big vibrating hopper. It has a conveyor that goes out from under the jaw crusher. And you can dump a whole box full of remnant into the vibrating hopper. And it vibrates it down into the crusher. And then the discharge conveyor takes it out and stacks into a pile or a tote or whatever. But right now, I'm going to show you some footage I took a couple years ago of the module, the hopper, the crusher, and then the conveyor. So it starts with the orange hopper behind me. It can be loaded with a tote or bin of scrap material. The hopper vibrates the material at an even rate down into the 6x30 jaw crusher here. Once the material is crushed, it falls down onto this conveyor belt, which can carry the material up and stack it into a pile, a box, or a bin for later use. Thank you.
So here's the material we crushed. The last couple pieces were some of that man-made quartz. And you can see that crushed it up pretty nice. And we crushed the whole barrel, I don't know, in maybe 5 minutes.
Now we're looking at the back of the 6x30 jaw crusher. And we can go over some simple things here. There's grease fittings here along the back of the movable jaw and one over there. And greasing about once a day is fine. And when the machine is new, you want to make sure that you build up a bead of grease here, which creates a seal and keeps the dust out. So in the first couple days of operation, make sure that a bead of grease is built up here. It doesn't need to be flinging off the shaft, but that's what creates the seal for the bearings. To adjust the jaw gap, these plates are spacers, which push out the shuttle and the toggle and conversely drives the jaw plates forward. So to increase the gap, you would take out some of these plates, which would pull all this back and open up the jaw plate. After that's done, this is the tensioning rod. This either needs to be tightened or loosened, depending on the adjustment to the jaw plate. If the jaw plate is opened up, this needs to be tightened to keep tension on the whole assembly back here so that it's not flopping around. These bolts here and here keep tension on the plates. And if you are going to add or remove plates, you loosen these bolts, and this large bolt pushes the whole mechanism forward. Then you would back this off a couple turns so you could pull these plates out. So that's in a nutshell how you adjust the jaw gap and the easy maintenance on the 6x30 jaw crusher.
So I hope you guys enjoyed the video of our 6x30 jaw crusher. If you have any questions or comments, you can find our contact information in the description below. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.